Live from the Ring of Fire, Mike Papantonio.
Look, Lyndon Baines Johnson, he was criticized by the Republicans for his nuclear Holocaust commercial, where a child was in the foreground of a camera shot, and the child was playing with a daisy, playing with a flower. The scene then cuts to the background of a mushroom cloud expanding across the screen, where a nuclear bomb was exploding in the background of the shot. The spot became known as the Daisy Ad, and it whipped Barry Goldwater completely. Johnson was in a presidential race with Barry Goldwater, who really was a true war hawk, the same caliber of Mitt Romney. The Republicans whined, and they made whiny, gurgling sounds like only Republicans can do, and LBJ pulled the ad after a little while that truthfully did capture what was possible for the world with a vote for Barry Goldwater. Now, I hesitate to compare Goldwater with Romney because Goldwater was an intellect, had a better intellect. He was more capable of filtering important information that might have pushed America towards world war with Russia and China. Goldwater was not an etch-a-sketch, blow-in-the-wind kind of conservative. He wasn't a snake oil salesman opportunist like Mitt. But I agree with Johnson. Goldwater surrounded himself with war pimps who were still reeling about Dwight D. Eisenhower pointing out that America's military-industrial complex was a true-to-life self-promotion operation, always looking for an opportunity to use their arsenal somewhere in the world. That's what Dwight D. Eisenhower said. If you're a parent and you're evaluating Mitt Romney, not according to how you believe he's going to handle the economy, but according to how dangerous Mitt is when it comes to potential global war catastrophe, you're right on, because that's what you ought to be thinking about. The media takes us somewhere else. We think about the economy. We think about this business. This is a dangerous man, especially compared to Barry Goldwater. Barry Goldwater had a brain. He at least could analyze what was real and what wasn't. But here's the 10,000-foot look at Mitt Romney. 60% of the foreign policy advisors he's already tapped to help him make decisions are the same war pimps that worked for Dick Cheney. Virtually every day, you can find one of them screaming for an attack on Iran, demanding a war with North Korea, promoting the idea of an invasion of Syria. Watch how China and Russia respond when both of them get their oil from Iran. Both these countries, China and Russia, they remind us that both of them are heavily invested in financing and trade with both Syria and Iran. China is actually helping build the infrastructure in Iran, roads, bridges, freeways. But let's invade Iran, according to Mitt. Mitt is so oblivious and tactless in urging Israel to go bomb the hell out of Iran, that he's morphing into a Dr. Strange lover. Worse yet, he's morphing into Dick Cheney, who, by the way, Mitt considers Dick his most trusted advisor on war policy. Mitt's second most trusted advisor on war policy is John Bolton, the dangerous, demented oddball who helped Mitt draw up his defense policy that was going to build 5 more warships than the military said they even want or even need. The Cheney-Mitt-Bolton plan would add 100,000-plus troops to our military ranks. It would increase Pentagon's fund money budget by another $200 billion and devote about 6% of the U.S. GDP to more military spending. There are no plans on what the military is going to even do with this money. This money, this gift money that's thrown around. The military doesn't even know what they would do with it. Pentagon says we don't even need that much money. But right now, there are not enough wars. There are not enough rumors of wars to satisfy Mitt, Dick Cheney, and John Bolton. But he appears to be looking ahead, anticipating his chance to start pushing missile buttons from the Oval Office. Most of us knew that W was going to be a childlike, impressionable kind of character. He was going to be impressed by the Warhawks were going to move him around however they wanted. The people he surrounded himself, these war pimps, they knew that they had their ace in the hole when W slipped into office. It wasn't that his eyes were too close together, or maybe he seemed incapable of original thought. We recognized the power and influence of an unchecked, wildly independent Pentagon with such an impressionable mind like W to work with. But can you visualize how wildly influenced and how wildly dominated Mitt Romney would be? It would be the equivalent of black Play-Doh in the hands of neo-nuts like Dick Cheney and John Bolton, just itching for another grand war. But China won't be playing with containment tactical weapons, ladies and gentlemen. And that's what should be scaring the hell out of soccer moms. Should be scaring the hell out of all of us. While we're thinking about economy, we ought to be thinking what's left after Mitt Romney. Between Russia and China capabilities, that mushroom cloud that LBJ used to scare the bejeebas out of voters, hell, it would look like a 4th of July fireworks in the park. The voiceover that LBJ used in the ad that I'm truly glad he delivered, that voiceover said that there was too much at stake to allow Barry Goldwater access to thermonuclear weapons. Johnson warned that voters in that ad, they need to take count of the idea that the stakes are too high, that you can't take a chance. The potential horror that LBJ talked about was just too great to stay at home when our children can either live in peace or move into a world that presents a new kind of nuclear threat and nuclear darkness. This is not an overemphasis of how dangerous Mitt Romney is. Follow his words. Follow everything he says as he tours around the Mideast. Go back and look at what he has said about the role of America where it comes to war policy. If you're thinking that this election is only about the economy, you are dead wrong. If you aren't seeing clouds behind a Mitt Romney presidency, bomb clouds, well, hell, you're not paying attention.
If we re-elect Barack Obama, Iran will have a nuclear weapon. And if we elect Mitt Romney, if you elect me as the next president, they will not have a nuclear weapon.
This is the Ed Schultz Show.